This week we're going to learn about cryptography. This is probably my favorite section in the course. I've always thought cryptography was fun. Cryptography is the study of methods to make and break secret codes. The process of disguising data to prevent unauthorized use is called encryption, and any particular method of disguising data is called an encryption scheme. We're going to look at four different encryption schemes in this section. Each one will have rules for replacing the letters of the original message with new letters to get an encrypted message. This is kind of a long section, so the video lecture will be broken up into two parts, with two encryption schemes in each part. Encryption was originally used mostly for military and diplomatic transmissions, but now encryption is used in a lot more places, and one of the most important ones is in protecting our personal information. Modern encryption schemes are much more complex than the ones that we're going to look at in this chapter. The first encryption scheme we're going to go over is the Caesar cipher, and this is one of the first known ways of encoding a message. In this type of encryption, each letter of the message is shifted by a given number of places to another letter in the alphabet. So this table here shows a Caesar cipher with a shift of 3. Each letter of the message you want to encrypt is replaced by the letter below it in the table. And you can see that the letter below is the letter that is 3 places to the right. So A is replaced by D, B is replaced by E, and so on. So if I wanted to encrypt this message, "The Visigoths are sacking Rome," then I would go up to my table here and I would see that T would get replaced with a W, H would be replaced with K, E would be replaced with H, and so on. So if I did that for each letter, I would get this encrypted message. Of course, this is only for shifting by 3 spaces, but the Caesar cipher can be used to shift by any number of places from 1 to 25. To make this encryption scheme and the ones that we're going to look at later easier to implement, we need a special kind of arithmetic called modular arithmetic. And we've already seen this a little bit before when we had A mod B to find remainders, where this is the remainder of A divided by B. This is actually modular arithmetic, so let's look a little bit closer at that. Although you might not know it, you probably use modular arithmetic fairly often. It's also sometimes called clock arithmetic because that's one of the most familiar places where you'll see it. If it is 9:30 a.m. right now and you want to know what time it will be in 7 hours, to figure that out you're going to add 7 hours to 9:30, which will make 16:30, and then subtract 12 to get 4:30 p.m. So what you're doing here is finding the remainder when you divide the hour by 12. So for any two whole numbers, a and n, we're going to define a modulo n, or a mod n for short, to be the remainder when a is divided by n. And again, you can calculate a mod n by just typing that into Google. We also saw how to find remainders either by long division or using a calculator in Chapter 16, Section 1. You can use either of those two methods also. The Caesar cipher is going to use modular arithmetic with n equal to 26, which is the number of letters of the alphabet. So let's go back to the Caesar cipher. Here I've labeled the letters of the alphabet 0 through 25 in this chart. Then to implement the Caesar cipher, first you need to choose a shift number S, which will be a number between 1 and 25. Then for each letter of the message you want to encrypt, you're going to find the corresponding number. So if I wanted to encrypt C, the corresponding number would be 2. And then replace that number with A plus S mod 26, and find the corresponding letter for the encrypted message. So if I was shifting by 4, and I had 2 plus 4 is 6, is still 6 mod 26, then the corresponding letter for the encrypted message would be G. So let's go ahead and look at an example of a secret Roman message. The Roman Emperor Trajan wants to leave a secret message for posterity, saying how great he is. He decides to carve the message "Trajan rules" on the base of one of the columns in his palace, but encrypt the message with a Caesar cipher with a shift of 8. So what should he carve? Well, the first step is to take my message, "Trajan rules," and find the numbers that correspond to the letters. So I'm going to start with T, and T is 19 on my chart. I'm going to put dashes in between to separate my numbers just to make it easier to read. R is 17, A is 0, J is 9, and then I've got another A, another 0. N is 13, so that's my first word. R, again, is 17, U is 20, L is 11, E is 4, and S is 18. So I've got the numbers corresponding to the letters in my message. I'm using a shift of 8, so I have S equals 8. And then for each number I see in up here, I need to find what that number plus 8 is mod 26. So I've just gone through and written down all the numbers I see up there. Some of them are repeated, like 0 and 17, so I've just got them once over here. 19 plus 8 is 27, mod 26 is equal to 1. 17 plus 8 is 25, mod 26 is still 25. Any number that is less than 26 is just going to stay the same. So 0 plus 8 is 8, mod 26 is still going to be 8. 9 plus 8 is 17, mod 26 equals 17. 13 plus 8 is 21, mod 26 equals 21. 20 plus 8 is 28, mod 26, and that's going to be equal to 2. 11 plus 8 is 19, mod 26 is going to be 19. 4 plus 8 is 12, mod 26 is equal to 12. And then finally, 18 plus 8 is 26, mod 26, which is equal to 0 because 26 divides itself evenly with no remainder. Alright, so now I can go up to these numbers and replace them with the new numbers that I've just found. So 19 is going to be replaced with a 1, 17 will be replaced with 25, 0 becomes an 8, 9 becomes 17, 0 is 8 again, and then 13 is 21, that's my first word. 17 is going to be replaced by 25, 20 is replaced by 2, 11 is replaced by 19, 4 is replaced by 12, and 18 is replaced by 0. So now I've got my shifted numbers for my encrypted message, and I just need to go back to my chart here and find the corresponding letters. So 1 is B, 25 is Z, 8 is I, 17 is R, another 8 is another I, 21 is V, that's my first word, 25 is Z, 2 is C, 19 is T, 12 is M, and 0 is A. So this is the encrypted message. This is Trajan rules encrypted with a Caesar cipher with a shift of 8. If we know the shift number that was used to encrypt a message, we can also decrypt or decode that message. And to do that, we're going to use another Caesar cipher, but this time with a shift number of 26 minus S, which will get you back to the original letter in the message. So in the example, we saw that using a shift of 8 on t took 19 to 1, so we replaced t with b. If we shift again on b with 26 minus 8, which is equal to 18, then that's going to take 1 back to 19. So b is going to be replaced with the original letter t, so it undoes the encryption. This next type of encryption scheme that we're going to look at is similar, but instead of adding, we're going to multiply in this one. And this is called the decimation cipher. So in this case, we're going to choose an odd number k between 3 and 25, but not 13. And the reason that we can't use even numbers or the number 13 is because this would encode more than one letter of the alphabet as the same new letter, so we wouldn't be able to undo the encryption easily. For each letter of the message, we're going to again find the corresponding number A using the same chart as before. And this time we're going to replace A with A times K mod 26, then go back to our chart and find the corresponding letter for the encrypted message. So let's go ahead and look at an example of the decimation cipher. Melville Dewey created the Dewey Decimal System in 1876 to organize library books. He uses a decimation cipher with multiplication by 5 to encode the message bookworm. And we want to find out what the encoded message will be. So again, I'm going to write down my message bookworm, and then for each letter I'm going to find the corresponding number in my chart up here. So B is 1, O is 14, K is 10, W is 22, I've got another O, so another 14, R is 17, and M is 12. So those are the numbers that correspond to the letters, and now I need to do my encryption, and I'm using multiplication by k equals 5 here. So for each number I see in my message, I'm going to take that number, multiply by 5, and find what that is, mod 26. So my first number that I see up here is 1, and 1 times 5 is 5, mod 26, which is equal to 5. Next I see 14, 14 times 5 is 70. And 70 mod 26 is equal to 18. 10 times 5 is 50. Mod 26 is going to be equal to 24. 22 times 5 is 110. Mod 26 is going to be equal to 6. 17 times 5 is 85. Mod 26 is equal to 7. And finally, 12 times 5 is 60. Mod 26 is going to be equal to 8. So now I can replace the numbers here with the new numbers that I just found. So 1 is going to be replaced by 5. 14 will be replaced by 18. 10 is replaced by 24. 22 is replaced by 6. 14 again is replaced by 18. 17 is replaced by 7. And 12 is replaced by 8. So those are the numbers for my encrypted message. And now I need to go back to my chart and find the corresponding letters. So 5 is F. 18 is S. So I've got a couple of S's. 24 is Y, 6 is G, 18 is S, 7 is H, and 8 is I. So this is the encrypted message bookworm using the decimation cipher with multiplication by 5. We can also decrypt the decimation cipher, and this is also going to be performing a different decimation cipher. If we know the value of k that was used to encrypt the message, then we need to find a number x so that k times x mod 26 equals 1. Then if we apply the decimation cipher again with multiplication by the number x, that is going to decrypt the message. So in the example, we had k equal to 5, and that took 14 to 18. This table over here shows the decryption value for each encryption value. So since k was equal to 5, to decrypt, I'm going to use x equal to 21, and that will take 18 back to 14, so that undoes the encryption. So that's the first part of this section, and then in the next video, we'll look at two more encryption schemes.